course, this tragedy hit very close to home for the Chilliwack Chiefs. Bus travel, often in difficult winter conditions, is part of our regular routine. A number of our chiefs have a very personal experience with the Humboldt victims. This includes our head coach, Jason Tatarnic. Jason?
I would like to thank everyone in attendance. I played against the Humboldt Broncos, and I coached the Humboldt Broncos. And I can tell you, when you hear the name Humboldt, you think of the Broncos. When you hear the name of the Broncos, Broncos are Humboldt, and Humboldt is the Broncos. It's a common theme in Saskatchewan. I'm willing to bet that the majority of Canadians didn't know there was a Humboldt in Saskatchewan. They do now. It was a tragic event that no words can describe. The 29 people on that bus were doing something they loved. The game will continue. Players will play. Coaches will coach. Trainers will treat players. They'll sharpen skates. Fans will continue to cheer, and teams will continue to play and travel on a bus. I ask you, when we leave here, remember this is a game. Players will make mistakes. Games will be won and lost. And yes, referees will miss a call here and there. It's only a game, but it's a beautiful game that brings people together. We will always remember the Humboldt Broncos in the community of Humboldt. Let's honor them by simply just loving everything this game represents. It brings people together, it brings memories, and I ask that we always honor how we play, how we cheer, and everything that we do in the game, we do it and we remember the Humboldt Broncos.
Finally, we'd like to hear from our team chaplain, McMahon.
Times like these, there are no words that can begin to touch the pain, the hurt, and the loss that are so very real for those closest to this tragedy. For the residents of Humboldt, for the Broncos organization, for the family and friends of those who have lost a loved one or are now at their bedsides. I also know that the impact of this tragedy extends far beyond those most immediately affected by it. I know this through my own experience of being a part of this hockey organization as a chaplain. I didn't grow up playing hockey. When I came here as a chaplain and first walked in the doors, I had no idea how I was going to be received. But I quickly realized that just by showing up and doing my best to care for the players and staff, that I would get adopted into this organization that is a lot more like a family than a sports team. And through my time with this club, I've also learned that this culture of family extends throughout the entire hockey community, at every level and in every league. So when there is a tragedy in the hockey community, regardless of where it occurs, it affects the whole hockey community. Because when someone in our family is hurt, we all hurt. And so I know the whole hockey community in Chilliwack and those connected to it are hurting during this time. When thinking about this memorial service, when thinking about the players and staff and volunteers of this organization and our community, and the community of the Humboldt Broncos, I was drawn to a single verse of poetry from a book in the Bible called Isaiah. It says this: "When you pass through the waters, I will be with you. And through the rivers, they shall not overwhelm you. When you walk through fire, you shall not be burned, and the flames shall not consume you. Two things grip me about this verse. First is the word when. The author knows the reality of the world that we live in and does not gloss over it. There will be times when we pass through the waters, when we pass through the rivers, when we pass through the fire. There will be times when there is grief, pain, hurt, and loss, just like this time we are passing through now, and the community of Humboldt is passing through now. But the second thing that gripped me about this passage was this: I will be with you. God will be with us. God is with us. Through the waters, through the rivers, through fire, through this time of grief we are passing through right now, God is with us. How is he with us? He is with us when we cry out in prayer. He is with us when we step outside and look up to the mountains and across the rivers. And he is with us when we gather together and come together and lean on each other. God is with us when we are with each other in times of tragedy. And you are already evidence of this. You are here today. And when there is a tragedy in the hockey community, the whole hockey community comes around those that are hurting, just like an extended family does, because that's what the hockey community is, a big family. We sit with them, we listen to them, we pray for them, and we show them that we love them. And while distance separates us from Humboldt, we can be with them in our thoughts, in our prayers, and in how we care for each other during this time of grief. No matter who you are, no matter your connection to hockey, even if there is no connection at all and you're just here because your heart breaks for what has happened, you can know this. As you go through these waters, these rivers, through this fire, God is with you and we are with you. And to the families and community of the Humboldt Broncos, we together say to you, God is with you, and we are with you. To demonstrate this in a moment, I'm going to invite you to stand and join me in a short prayer. But when we stand together, this will be a tangible demonstration of standing with each other and standing with the families and community of the Humboldt Broncos. It can be our way of saying, we are with you. So please stand if you're able. God, we come before you in a time of tragedy where words just fail us. And yet we trust that in the midst of this time, in the midst of these waters, these rivers, this fire, that you are with us and that you have called us, you have created us to be with each other. So no matter how we are feeling or what our connection is to this community, what has happened, may we know that we are not alone in this, that we have each other, and may the community of the Humboldt Broncos and the family members of the Humboldt Broncos know that they are not alone, that you are with them, and that we are with them. I pray these things in the name of Jesus. Amen. Thank you.